Could Campi Flegrei supervolcano trigger a global catastrophe? Imagine a volcano so powerful that it could darken skies across the globe and alter the course of human history. Now realize that this volcano isn't a towering mountain in a remote jungle. It's lurking beneath the picturesque landscapes of southern Italy. In the shadow of the famous Mount Vesuvius lies Campi Flegrei, a massive supervolcano right under the city of Naples. This hidden giant has the potential to wreak havoc on a scale far beyond Pompeii's ancient disaster, and scientists say it might be stirring from its long slumber. Beneath the bay and towns west of Naples, Campi Flegrei, burning fields in Italian, sprawls as a vast underground volcano. Unlike the classic cone-shaped volcano, Campi Flegrei is a caldera, essentially a giant cauldron-like crater formed when a volcano's top collapses after an enormous eruption. Instead of one big mountain, there's an 8-mile-wide volcanic field, pockmarked with 24 craters and geysers steaming with sulfur. Many of these features are hidden under the blue waters of the Gulf of Pozzuoli, or obscured by urban development, making it hard to realize you're standing on a volcano at all. It's hard to believe, but over 1.5 million people live atop this volcanic complex, with about 500,000 residing right within the caldera itself. By comparison, this supervolcano makes Vesuvius, which destroyed Pompeii in AD 79, look like a smaller cousin. Campi Flegrei doesn't have a single iconic peak, but don't let that fool you. It is one of the most powerful volcanic systems on Earth, and perhaps the most dangerous volcano in Europe, according to many researchers. To understand why Campi Flegrei is so feared, we need to travel back nearly 40,000 years. Back then, early humans and Neanderthals roamed Europe, until one day, the ground in Italy exploded with unfathomable force. Campi Flegrei unleashed an eruption known as the Campanian Ignimbrite, the largest volcanic eruption Europe has seen in the last 200,000 years. This ancient mega-eruption blasted out hundreds of cubic kilometers of ash and rock. By some estimates, nearly a trillion gallons of molten rock were flung out of the earth. Imagine an ash cloud towering into the sky and spreading across continents. The fallout blanketed huge parts of Europe in ash and likely plunged the climate into a sudden winter. In fact, scientists think the eruption triggered a year without a summer, a period of profound cooling similar to what was observed after the 1815 Tambora eruption that caused crop failures around the world. At this point, you might be wondering, why are these supervolcanoes so powerful? Supervolcano isn't a formal scientific term, but it's become shorthand for volcanoes capable of producing the largest eruptions on Earth. Technically, a supervolcano is defined by an eruption rating of VEI-8 on the Volcanic Explosivity Index, meaning it blasted out over 1,000 cubic kilometers of material in one go. To put that in perspective, 1,000 cubic kilometers 240 times the volume of Mount St. Helens' 1980 eruption. These eruptions are so massive they often form giant calderas. The ground collapses into the emptied magma chamber, creating a huge crater tens of kilometers across. Campi Flegrei's largest eruption was just shy of this super eruption benchmark, VEI-7, but other supervolcanoes in Earth's past have hit VEI-8. One famous example is Yellowstone in the United States, often cited as the textbook supervolcano. Yellowstone's largest known eruption, 2.1 million years ago, spewed out an astonishing 2,450 cubic kilometers of debris, leaving a caldera about 70 kilometers wide. Another is Toba in Indonesia, which about 74,000 years ago erupted roughly 2,800 cubic kilometers of magma, the largest eruption on Earth in the last 2 million years. These eruptions are hundreds of times more powerful than any eruption in recorded human history. They blanket continents in ash, send shockwaves around the globe, and inject so much sulfur and ash into the atmosphere that they can cool the planet. Why are supervolcanoes so powerful? The secret lies in their magma chambers. enormous reservoirs of molten rock beneath the surface that can build up for hundreds of thousands of years. Over time, magma accumulates along with dissolved volcanic gases. In a supervolcano, this chamber can grow to be tens of kilometers wide. Think of it like a massive pressure cooker. The longer it stews, the more dissolved gas and magma volume build up. If the pressure gets high enough, and the rock above can't contain it, the whole system can rupture catastrophically. When that happens, magma doesn't just seep out. It explodes out violently as gas comes out of solution, fragmenting the magma into billions of tons of ash and pumice blasted high into the sky. It's important to note that calling Campi Flegrei a supervolcano doesn't mean every eruption it has will be apocalyptic. In fact, most eruptions at supervolcanoes are smaller than the doomsday VI-8 blasts. You might be wondering, if Campi Flegrei was so violent in the distant past, what has it done lately? The volcano's most recent eruption happened in 1538, and although it was tiny compared to the prehistoric blasts, it still made history. For centuries before that eruption, the ground in the caldera had been rising, hinting that pressure was building below. Then, in 1538, the ground swelled dramatically by up to 66 feet in elevation and finally burst open. The eruption lasted 8 days straight and spewed so much ash and lava that it buried an entire village and built a new hill out of volcanic debris, today known as Monte Nuovo, or New Mountain. Imagine waking up to find a new mountain literally erupted into existence in your backyard. Residents of the area at the time were astounded and terrified, but in the grand scheme, the 1538 event was a small eruption for Campi Flegrei. It was over in about a week and relieved some pressure from the underground magma system. After that, the giant went quiet. In fact, Campi Flegrei has not erupted since 1538, but that doesn't mean it's been sleeping peacefully. Over the last several decades, Campi Flegrei has shown worrisome signs that it's far from dead. Earth tremors shake the region frequently, and the ground has been rising and falling as if the volcano is breathing underground. Since the 1950s, there have been episodes where the land in the caldera bulged upward dramatically, a phenomenon known as bradyseism, meaning slow earthquake. In the early 1980s, the port town of Pozzuoli, which sits at the center of the caldera, rose by several feet in just a couple of years, cracking buildings and roads. This alarming uplift was accompanied by intense swarms of small quakes. By 1983, the shaking was strong enough to cause structural damage. Thousands of residents were evacuated as officials feared an eruption might be imminent. Then the ground subsided slightly and the immediate crisis passed that time. This restlessness continues today. The ground at Pozzuoli is now rising by about 4 inches each year, and overall, the area has swelled roughly 13 feet higher than it was in the 1950s. So we know Campi Flegrei is a huge volcano with a cataclysmic past. But what's happening there now? Lately, it's been making headlines with increased earthquakes and ground deformation. Is Campi Flegrei stirring again? And if so, what might be coming? Is Campi Flegrei waking up? The Italian government isn't taking chances. In 2012, officials raised the volcano's alert status from green to yellow, officially putting it under active scientific monitoring. Scientists have installed a dense network of sensors, satellite trackers, and cameras around the caldera. They keep watch on every shiver of the ground and every whiff of volcanic gas seeping up. Research studies in the last few years have warned that magma deep below is heating up and releasing gases, which increases pressure. One study identified that the volcano may be approaching a critical degassing pressure point at which the rock above the magma could fracture, potentially leading to an eruption. In other words, the pressure cooker under Naples is heating up. And this brings us to our question, what if it erupts? It's the scenario no one in Naples wants to imagine, yet it's one that must be considered, an eruption at Campi Flegrei. The scale of impact would depend hugely on the size of the eruption. Campi Flegrei could erupt in many ways, from a small lava outpouring to an ash-producing explosion to, in the worst case, another cataclysmic caldera-forming event. Let's break down the risks. The most likely eruption, if one were to occur in the coming years, would probably be moderate-sized, something similar to the 1538 Monte Nuovo eruption, or a bit larger, say VAI 3 or 4. Even a moderate eruption could be disastrous given the population density. Immediate local effects would include intense ashfall and pyroclastic flows. In the heart of the Campi Flegrei caldera, there's a designated red zone of about 500,000 residents. These people are in the area most at risk of being hit by pyroclastic flows, the fast-moving, super-hot avalanches of ash and gas. Those flows can travel several kilometers, so communities around Pozzuoli and western Naples could be devastated if such flows occur. Ash would likely blanket the city of Naples and much of the surrounding region, potentially accumulating thickly enough to collapse roofs, foul water supplies, and paralyze transportation. One risk analysis by researchers considered a hypothetical VEI3 eruption at Campi Flegrei, a modest scenario, and estimated staggering impacts. 2.5 million people would be affected by about 2 centimeters of ashfall, enough to disrupt transport, choke machinery, and require cleanup. 144,000 people would be in areas receiving around 25 centimeters of ash, deep ash capable of causing structural damage to buildings, roofs collapsing, etc. 200,000 people could be exposed to pyroclastic density currents, the technical term for pyroclastic flows and surges, which would be almost certainly fatal to anyone caught in their path and cause total destruction of structures. In addition to these direct effects, there are other hazards. Because part of Campi Flegrei is under the bay, an explosive eruption interacting with water could trigger tsunamis in the Bay of Naples. A fast-moving pyroclastic flow entering the sea or an underwater explosion can displace water and send waves toward coastal areas. The nearby island of Ischia and coastal neighborhoods could be hit by such waves, adding a secondary disaster on top of the eruption. Then there's the issue of volcanic gases. An eruption would release huge quantities of gases like sulfur dioxide. While the dramatic effects of these gases occur high in the atmosphere, cooling the climate by forming sulfuric acid droplets, at ground level they can also cause asphyxiation or acid rainfall. Even without an eruption, the high levels of CO2 in the area have in the past resulted in incidents. For example, in 2017, sudden release of CO2 in a mud pool tragically suffocated some visitors at Solfatara. During an eruption, CO2 and SO2 would elevate local health risks, and air quality could be dangerous in the broader region. On a larger scale, if Campi Flegrei had a large eruption, VEI 6 or 7, the consequences would extend far beyond Italy. Such an eruption would loft ash into the high atmosphere, potentially disrupting climate patterns. Even a VEI 5, similar to Mount Pinatubo 1991, can cause measurable global cooling for a year or two. An eruption of Campi Flegrei could also create an aviation nightmare. Remember the 2010 Eyjafjallajökull eruption in Iceland, which grounded flights across Europe? Campi Flegrei could be much worse. Experts note that an ash-rich eruption from Campi Flegrei would pose a significant risk to European air travel, likely surpassing the 2010 Iceland disruption. It's not all doom and gloom. There is a scenario where Campi Flegrei might have a small eruption or even just release pressure gently. Volcanoes can relieve pressure through increased fumarolic activity or minor eruptions that don't escalate. In the best case, Campi Flegrei might just settle down again after a period of unrest, as it did in the 1980s. But because of the stakes, everyone must prepare for the worst even while hoping for the best. This duality, high impact but low probability, is what makes planning for supervolcanoes so tricky. So, is this supervolcano about to erupt? Probably not tomorrow or next month, but it is restless, and that in itself is cause for attention. Campi Flegrei has surprised humanity before, and it certainly has the power to do so again. Our task is to respect that power stay informed by the science, and be prepared. Whether you're a science enthusiast pondering volcanic mysteries, or a resident of Naples keeping a cautious eye on the Phlegraean fields, Campi Flegrei is a reminder of the dynamic planet we live on.